I can do anything. I can reach any goal today. I can do what I want. I can be what I want to be.
Hi guys, my name is Lettie and I'm a chef, and I'm going to show you how to make Martha Garland's meatloaf. Stay tuned. Okay guys, here are the ingredients that you are going to need for your meatloaf. You're going to need about 2.5 pounds of ground beef. I got like 1.25 pounds of 85/15 and 1.25 pounds of 96% lean for 96.4%. But you can use whatever you want. These are what I choose for this recipe, but in general, 2.5 pounds of ground beef. You don't want it to be super high fat content, even though that tastes better, because you want it to maintain its size. For herbs, you're going to need a sprig of rosemary, a handful of parsley, and a handful of basil, one large onion, a red pepper and a green pepper, and I might only use half. I'm gonna see how much they render. Half a stick of butter and red wine, fresh black pepper and salt, of course, my Montreal steak seasoning, garlic powder and onion powder, some beef bouillon, seasonal, sugats, of course, which is sugar. Also, for that little topping, you're going to need ketchup, mustard, sugar, and some Worcestershire, which I didn't get out, but you're going to need some Worcestershire sauce. And the funny ingredients, this elephant in the room, Kellogg's cornflakes. Yeah, that's right, Kellogg's cornflakes. All right, guys, the first thing I'm gonna do is chop my onion and my peppers, and I'll show you how.
Also, guys, you're going to need extra virgin olive oil. I forgot to say that. Okay guys, so as I hope you can see, I have skinned my onion, and I'm gonna show you how I do my peppers. I cut the top off of my pepper, and then I just clean out the inside. I just put it down the sink. Give it a little rinse, because it's pretty seedy. And I'm gonna do the same thing to the green one. I'm gonna cut the top off. And I'm going to empty the inside. Give it a little rinse. Make sure the other end doesn't have one of those little tags on it, which they don't. All right, I need to get a knife. Okay guys, so I got out a really big skillet and I put half a stick of butter in it. And now I'm going to put about 1/8 cup of extra virgin olive oil. EVOO, as Rachel Ray classically tagged that name. And then I'm going to cut my
I'm gonna put that on warm. Like, actually, I'm gonna put it on like 5. And I'm gonna cut my onion. You know what, guys? I feel so guilty that I haven't bought any garlic lately. Like, what kind of Italian am I, not having fresh garlic in this house? I do have some garlic paste that I'm going to probably put a little bit in. But at any rate, yeah, I am cutting my onion like fairly small for sure. And this is a big onion, and I'm pretty sure that I'm going to do 2 smaller meatloafs as opposed to 1 very large meatloaf. You could actually cut this recipe in half if you wanted to. My friend Jen's mother-in-law is in some assisted care right now. She had an operation. Mike's mom, actually the people that were in my vlog today, but you might not know about that. But at any rate, I think I'm gonna make them a whole meatloaf so they have dinner. And her mom has something different to eat besides hospital food. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna put this onion in my pan. And I'm actually gonna put my pan up to 7. It's awful that I don't have a gas stove, but that's life. At my restaurant, I had a gas stove and I basically cooked everything there. Like even my food that we would eat at home, obviously. This was a huge onion. Like I'm talking huge. At any rate, I wanted to tell you know, food to me is such a personal thing. And, you know, it's my passion. It's definitely one of my passions. And that is way too close. So, oh my goodness. Let's go ahead and back that out. And you know, it's one of those senses, kind of like smell. You know how when you smell a certain smell, how it can immediately take you back to your childhood? Or I think our senses are such amazing gifts. And I feel it's that way with food as well. That's why I love traditional foods and stuff to do over and over again so your children can remember those flavors, or, you know, your family, your friends. And this particular meatloaf was inspired by a woman in my life whose name was Martha Garland. And I know she wouldn't mind me telling her name. Her daughter and my mother were very best friends. And she was like a grandmother to me, as Judy, her daughter's children, were friends with my sister and myself our whole life. And this recipe, I'll never forget when I asked her for her recipe, because I personally am not much of a meatloaf person. It's probably one of my husband's favorite foods. Here I am, basically a gourmet chef, and my husband's top favorite food is tacos, hot dogs, meatloaf, pizza. One man's trash is another man's treasure. I don't know what to tell you. But at any rate, he loves meatloaf. So he asked me to make meatloaf, so that's why I'm making meatloaf. But at any rate, it's not a very, you know, it's usually a dump, and this is a little bit more sophisticated meatloaf, you know? But at any rate, I hope you like this recipe and it becomes part of your life. Because food
and sharing my recipes. It feels so good to share. It feels so good to share. So at any rate, that's our therapy session for this cooking show. Go ahead and look at our onions. I got them going. And next I'm going to do the same thing with the peppers. You see them? And never burn your onions, guys. Don't let them onions get brown. Oh, I'm looking at it the wrong place. Don't let those onions get brown. And I'm gonna go ahead and I am going to cut my green and red pepper. Now, peppers for me, I don't use peppers that much. I like them. I don't know that they actually agree with me very well. It's probably the one food that I notice, you know, after I eat it, I can still taste it. I feel like I can't get rid of peppers. So I think I am going to only use half of the red and the green peppers. And if you want, if you like peppers, that is one thing about my recipes. The recipes that I share here on YouTube, I mean, I'm an Italian chef, French infused, but the recipes that I share on Facebook or on YouTube are simple, home, family, easy to do recipes. We're not foaming anything here, you know. We are, the recipes that I give on here are the ones that are really hard to mess up. They're, you know, if you want it to taste exactly how mine tastes, then do it exactly how I do it. But if you have different tastes, a different palate, and you prefer something else, my recipes are very hard to wreck if you stick to the basic, because they're so good. And you can add your own touch. Like, that's the really cool thing. I love it when somebody says that, yeah, oh, I have your meatloaf recipe, I love it, but instead of doing the red peppers, I do pimentos because I don't like cutting it up and I don't use green onions. And it's like, I love that though. Like, that's awesome. It's still part of me that I gave you. At any rate, I'm burning my onions probably. I'm not. But I am gonna turn this down now. I'm gonna turn it down to 4 and I'm going to continue. I'm gonna shut up and I'm going to continue to cut these peppers. Now the peppers, I prefer diced fairly small. So once I run my knife down here, I'm probably gonna walk it back and forth a couple times still, because I really want this just to be smaller specks of green peppers, green and red peppers in my meatloaf. That's about, that's pretty small. Could be even smaller if you don't want to taste a big piece of pepper. You know, as I cook my food, I look at everything that I'm chopping and I imagine it going into somebody's mouth. How's that gonna taste? How's it gonna fit with everything else that I'm putting in the recipe, you know? I think that's important to do. All right, I would say that's small enough. Nice little half and half of color. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna put them in with my onions. Now this is when the recipe goes a little bit left field from the normal, meatloaf recipe. Because I'm going to put in my fresh herbs now. And I'm going to completely butcher this basil. So I hope
no real chefs are really watching me right now, especially for a meatloaf recipe. I'm just gonna walk my knife right down these leaves. And then I'm going to go back through. I'm gonna turn it sideways. I'm gonna go back through so the julienne is not so long. And I'm gonna put my basil in there. Next, I'm gonna take my handful of parsley and I'm going to remove any big stems I see. And I'm gonna chop that up as well. And the same goes for the parsley. You don't want to have any huge pieces of parsley in your meatloaf, so you wanna chop it. And you know what, guys? I just prefer fresh herbs. If you wanna use dried parsley and dried rosemary and dried basil, please feel free. It will not mess the recipe up. It alters the taste, obviously, a little bit differently, but you're still gonna get a really good meatloaf. That's the bottom line. All right. I've had a long day today. I probably could have chopped that a little bit better, but I didn't. But that's okay. And then I'm going to do my rosemary. And how you do a fresh rosemary is you just skin it down the stem and put all those little needles on the board. And then you just start chopping. Just walk your knife down it. You see some stray ones, tell them to get over here. Chop them in there. And rosemary, you definitely want to get these pretty small. In general, unless you're a rosemary freak like me, I'll tell you what, if I have bad breath, I just take a sprig of that rosemary and chew on it. It's awesome. But I don't have bad breath. Okay? Don't get it twisted. I'm just saying on a bad day. All right. I got this pretty powdered down, nice and minced. And I'm going to go ahead and put that in there as well. Now, it's going to get even funkier. Because I am going to take, that's the wrong one. Oh, look at me. You know the one bad thing about making YouTube videos is you can't watch YouTube while you're cooking. Like, I have Rochelle on hold till I'm done. Anyways, okay, let me put this over here because I am going to take my oh, well, why did you do that? I don't know what happened. It's because I don't have this tightened down, guys. I'm still learning. Bear with me. I think that's okay. Sorry I dropped you. I'm going to take my onion powder, and I'm going to dust it across the top twice. And then I'm going to take my garlic powder and I'm going to dust it across the top twice. And like I said before, if you want to use fresh garlic, you can. Just you do the equivalent of like 2 teaspoons of minced garlic. And I'm going to save the seasonal for the meat, actually. Now I'm going to take some beef bouillon, and I am going to put in a heaping tablespoon.
Like what I have is a half a tablespoon, and I put as much as I could on there. And I'm gonna do it again. Like people, as much as I can. And then, of course, if you know me, I'm gonna sprinkle the top of these vegetables with some sugar. It's probably the equivalent of a teaspoon. And also, if you know me, I'm going to douse it with Montreal steak seasoning. And I'm gonna douse my meat with it as well. And now I'm gonna take some red wine. I'm going to probably use, how much is this? 3 times 5.6 ounce servings. So there's about 15, 20 ounces in here. So I'm gonna say about a cup. A cup of red wine, between a cup and 10 ounces. And then I'm gonna stir it. I can never find a spoon when I'm doing these videos. Okay, I'm gonna have to use this. Sorry. Okay, I am going to stir this all up. And I'm gonna turn the heat way down because we do not have to totally cook our onions right now. All we're doing is basically making a wet mixture that we're gonna mix with the cornflakes to put in the meatloaf. So now that I have all my seasoning in there, I'm going to work with the meat. Again, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna turn that off.
Okay guys, I've done a couple things while I was gone. I peeled 7 potatoes. I prefer russet. Unless I'm roasting, even for roasting, I prefer russet potatoes. I peeled 7 russet potatoes, put them in 7 cups of water, and I added 8 teaspoons, the equivalent of 8 bouillon chicken cubes. Yes. Boil your potatoes in chicken broth. Oh my goodness. It makes the best mashed potatoes ever.
And then I took a cup of ketchup. I couldn't think of what it was called. 2 tablespoons of mustard. And a 1/4 cup of brown sugar, and I put it in a warm saucepan. I have it on low, and I wanted to show you, I'm gonna kind of just douse over my brown sugar. So I would say that is a good tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. Then I'm gonna take some Himalayan salt and I'm gonna salt it. And I'm gonna let that melt down just a little bit. You really don't have to do this. I like to melt it and just incorporate all those flavors. I also will take a little bit of garlic powder and go over the top. And my usual, if you guys cook with me a lot,
If you watch my what's in my spice rack, I pretty much use the same spices over and over and over again. Okay, so I have that on one, and I'm gonna just give it a good stir. I'm gonna mash my brown sugar, and I'm gonna let this make a glaze.
I'm sorry, guys. I wasn't paying attention and my battery went out. At any rate, I was telling you that I am going to stir this up and let it just marry all the flavors, and this is gonna be a glaze on top of our meatloaves or loaf. One big one, two small ones. I honestly think it's better to make two small ones. I don't know. At any rate, that's what I'm gonna do with that. Now, I'm not gonna turn my potatoes on until my meatloaves go in the oven because they are going to be an hour cooking. All right. Oh my goodness, you guys. What's up with that? I can't get this thing to tighten. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. All right, let me do the meat. It won't stay there. It won't tighten. What's up with that? Is it this one? No. Oh, I just hope it stays there. I feel like it's not going to. Tell me if it drops, because I'm not looking this way. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put my 2.5 pounds of beef in my bowl. And I'm going to completely dust this meat with salt. And then I'm going to dust it with seasonal. And I'm going to do the seasonal on both sides. Ew, I'm just going to pretend I turned it over. This is for the other side. And of course, Montreal steak seasoning. I'm going to put that much. For you bakers who like to measure everything, I would say that's a good tablespoon and a half. And are you still there? Are you still with me? Now, here comes the fun part. I'm gonna get myself, even though I don't have any spoons to do it, proper spoons that is, I'm gonna kind of mash this out. And then I am going to put on top of this ground beef my Kellogg's cornflakes. Now, I'm probably going to do 2 cups. We'll see how that looks after I get it in there. This is a cup. You guys can see why I do not like baking, because I don't like anything perfect. 1 and 2. I'm gonna say 2.5. I can already tell I want more. 2.5 cups of cornflakes. And this is what I'm gonna do. I am going to, I think I'm gonna need more than 2.5 cups, but at any rate, I am going to pour this mixture right over my beef. And I'm gonna kinda let those cornflakes soak up that yummy wine. Olive oil, butter, and all those herbs and seasonings. Soaking it all up. And
And it is really warm too. And I'm kind of trying to let it give it cool down for a minute. Actually, I am gonna let it cool down for a minute before I stir that really hot mixture into that cold ground beef. That doesn't sit well with me, you know? You know, if it's not one thing, it's another with these. I just got a new tripod, and now I don't know how to make this tight. I'll tell you people, this YouTube is a job. It's a J-O-B. Don't underestimate these poor people who make these videos every day, because it's hard. But I do love it, because I like sharing. I can hear my cornflakes. They sound like Rice Krispies popping. All right. It's just getting cooler. It's getting cooler. I'm still gonna let that sit on there for a minute. I'm gonna say, let that cool down before you stir it in a good 4 minutes, 4 to 5 minutes. Make it 6 if you wanna make a phone call. Okay, I'm back, it's cooled down, and I'm gonna go ahead and stir it, and I'm gonna see if I want to add some more cornflakes or not. Maybe not. I want to stir it very well, but I believe that you can over stir ground meat in general. Like, don't beat a dead horse. Once you get everything incorporated, you're good to go. The funny thing is I'm trying to think of anything else that I put in here. Oh, you know what I am gonna do? I'm gonna put a couple shakes of Worcestershire sauce in here as well. Just for that, I don't know, Worcestershire is great with beef. That was probably a tablespoon. I need a drink of water. I'll be back. Also, guys, you know what? Let's turn our oven on at 350 and preheat it. And make sure that your rack is in the middle before you preheat your oven. I happen to know mine is. I already checked it. All right, don't fall. So I'm gonna go ahead and stir that Worcestershire in. And it's so funny that I did just go to my friend Jen's house because she had one of my meatloaf pans. Had I not dropped by there, I wouldn't have both pans to be able to do two meatloafs, and I would have ended up doing one huge meatloaf. Because I do have a larger bread pan. Because this is definitely a lot of meatloaf. Like I said, you can cut it in half and just do one smaller one if you prefer. All right, this is nice and mixed up. I'm gonna go ahead. This is from sheer experience. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna salt this one more time. I'm gonna dust it all over twice. I can almost smell that needs some salt. How good am I? All right, mix up. Now I am going to spray my two Pyrex glass meatloaf pans, and I'm going to put my beef in it. I'll be right back and I'll show you. Okay guys, I got my two pans. I'm gonna make sure I get the sides. Give the bottom a spray. And then I'm gonna basically split this down the center and just put my meat in, and I will pat them down when I'm done. Second one. If you kind of split it in half in the bowl first, it's easy to tell how to get them fairly equal. Go ahead, put this in the sink and rinse it out. All right. That's it. I quit. No, I don't. Never, ever give up. Be quiet, guys. All right. I'm kind of shaping this into a meatloaf. You know how a meatloaf kind of sticks up in the center, goes down on the sides? And then I'm going to kind of shine it up a little bit with my spoon so it doesn't have those rough edges. And I have the wrong spoon to do this because it has holes in it. Actually, I'm going to use this spoon. Much better, Lettie. Much better. All right, so you see how I kind of smoothed it, pushed my spoon down on the edges to give it kind of a, looks like a little hill. Need to push some to that side. He's a little bit lopsided. And then I am actually going to take my spoon and kind of dent the middle of this loaf. And what that is for is to actually let our glaze kind of get down in the center. So when we cut it, everybody has a nice little hunk of that glaze on top of their meatloaf. All right. Now I have my glaze over here. It's nice and warm. I'm gonna take this glaze, make sure it's all nice and stirred. And I'm gonna put half on one and half on the other. Are you still with me? I'm gonna go right down the center. Right down the center, and then just let it kind of fall everywhere once I've got it split well. I'm gonna put this in the sink. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna just spread it. Now I'm gonna let that main center stay there because it actually kind of bakes in that mold. You'll see how it happens. No, don't bark right now. So I'm just going to kind of even it out like it's a hill again. And these meatloaves are ready to go into the oven at 350 for 1 hour. I'm gonna go ahead and put them in the oven, and in about 15 minutes I'm gonna turn my potatoes on and I'll be back. Okay guys, here they are, absolutely delicious. We had a piece
I'm sorry that I didn't get to come back right when they came out of the oven. I was using this SIM card to download something else. In the meantime, it is almost 11 o'clock at night and I am ready for bed. So I'm not gonna show my face anymore. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. I can tell you right now, it's delicious and you'll make it over and over again. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please share it, maybe subscribe, and I'll see you in the kitchen. Ciao.
I can do anything. I can reach any goal today. I can do what I want. I can be what I want to be.